Hi everyone, my name is Prajit Shrestha and I'm currently studying computer science at Kathmandu University. I'm sure you have seen a lot of user interface design that have made you drop your jaws or roll your eyes. From a very simple yet beautiful piece of work to something that made you realize if hell really exists or not. However, what all of the good designs have in common is that these 8 rules that they follow while creating something that they connect with you and your emotions. These rules are called the 8 golden rules of interface design. But I won't be telling you what these rules are because that would be too boring. Instead, today we'll be looking at some web trends in 2020 and connect them with these golden rules to make it more practical and relevant. Let's talk about the first rule, strive for consistency. Do not change your fonts, menu, position or even color every time someone visits your web design. It's very dynamic and gets confusing when someone revisits your web page. When you are talking about being consistent in your design, you talk about fonts, alignment and color. And remember, a consistent interface will allow your user to complete their tasks and goal much more easily. This rule is something that is applied in every trending design. One good example is that this website called roserlab.com. Each page has a color palette and a font which are aligned at same position on every page. And there is no contrast between where to look and how to navigate. Plus, this bubble animation has made the design more vibrant and interactive. Rule number 2. Enable frequent user to use shortcuts. While we are talking about using shortcut in user interface or UI, what we really need to know is that user likes to get things done with less effort and time, which means using some abbreviation, function keys or hidden commands or even micro facilities where your user will be benefited from this shortcut, especially when they need to complete the tasks often. You can take an example of video skipping with numbers on website like YouTube or overlapping layers video content trends or some shortcut keys on your operating system. Rule number 3. Offer informatic feedback. Your users are your top concern. You need to make them update about where they are, what they did and what is happening. This kind of feedback needs to be meaningful, relevant, clear and fit the context. That will help the user to feel more comfortable with your system and increase the usability time. One simple example is how you click on subscribe button of our channel and a small text on the left bottom corner pops up to tell you what you did. Similarly, we can go to Roserlab to see how website interacts with user to give them how the bubble is about to burst and how it gets bigger every time we scroll down. Rule number 4. Design dialogue to yield closure. The less user has to guess, the better it is. Once a task is completed, give some peace of mind to your user by providing them informative feedbacks and will define option for next step if that's the case. Don't keep them wondering. The way you do it is by directing user to next web page or page with directions. Like you can see here that each section has the clarity on what to do, so you don't have to guess what it is and what is going on. One common example is a loading screen. Rule number 5. Offer simple error handling. A good interface should be designed to avoid error as much as possible, but when error do happens, your system needs to make it easy for user to understand the issue and know how to solve it. A simple way to handle error is to include display clearly about the error notification along with the clear hints to solve it. Like you can see, when you leave a compulsory part in Google Form, it shows an error, and where is that error? Rule number 6. Permit easy reversal of actions. Having a good user interface means there must be an option to undo and redo operations, which allows the user to easily reverse their actions in case the user performs some actions that will have a negative consequences in the future or they want to change it otherwise. Rule number 7. Support internal locus of control. It is important to give control and freedom to your users so that they are able to feel that they are in control of the system. Avoid surprises, interruptions and anything that has not been promoted by the user. User should be the initiator of the actions rather than the responders. Like you can see how you are in control of everything and every actions in this Google Calendar website. Rule number 8. Reduce short-term memory load. Recognizing something is easier than remembering it. You can minimize user's memory load by making objects, actions, and options easy to remember and universal. The user should not have to remember information from one part of dialogue to another. Instructions should be visible. This example, when you look at it, does not give you too much pressure on recalling things. Instead, it is very intuitive and easy to understand. Although you need to have your own creativity and make your own decision, this set of rules and guidelines will aid you in right direction and will allow you to have and get more usability in your early design process. This is the end of our video and our assessment. We would like to thank you, Mr. Sushil Shrestha, for giving us this opportunity. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe and healthy. Bye bye.